sounds more impressive when people read what you've done than when you're like, oh, I did that. Oh, yeah. And there's nothing like having somebody else, like another writer, kind of give you a little compliment on your piece. So I want to thank Josh for doing that. I'm the one that wrote that piece about Google. So we're going to mix it up, and I'm going to do a little prose piece. I'm one of those people that I think I wish I could write poetry, but can't. So if any of you know of any, like, poetry writing workshops for prose writers that are like totally freaked out of writing poetry, let me know. So this piece is one of the pieces that was in the book. So it's on page 193. Long, and I'm probably going to read about half of it because it's in the book. Politics as usual. The red carpet rolls. The musicians strike first G major in Elgar's pomp and circumstance. This is it. Facebook rises, runs his hands across the lapel of his black coat, and pushes open the door. And then slowly, intentionally, with one foot in front of the other, he walks down the aisle, keeping the 4x4 time signature. Facebook nods as he passes the rows of words gazing backward. He takes it all in, savors this once-in-a-lifetime moment. This day is the most important day of his life. This day he has been accepted into the institution, the establishment as a word, imprinted, defined for time and world. Facebook reaches the head of the altar and the formal part of the ceremony begins. American Webster stands at the helm holding ritual. He signals the crowd to be seated and gestures to Facebook to place one hand on the book and the other hand in the air. In his dies, on this day, the ceremony proceeds in original Latin. After a series of passages extolling the virtues of man and word, the ceremony reaches its pinnacle in New English. Webster recites, Visio Libri, Facebook. Are you a social utility tool that connects people with friends and others who work, study, or live around them? Facebook responds, I am. Webster continues, do you, Facebook, accept your placement on page 335, column 2, line 43, Facebook lowers his neck in ceremonial acceptance. Garlanded, he turns to face the audience, the stadium of words. Now it's his turn to address the 1,559 pages seated around him. Although he has his 30-second speech pinned under his lapel, the crowd, the moment, the glory of the day, provokes a raw, off-the-cuff address. Hello, hi everyone, I'm so thrilled to be here. Really, it's an honor. I never thought I'd be, well, you don't want to really hear that just now. I just wanted to say that I'll do my best to honor the traditions here, and, I really want to be your friend. Facebook steps away from the pulpit, an awkward pause between the two confirms Webster's displeasure. But before Facebook can glance an apology, he's ushered to his page, between facade and facsimile. Facade outstretches his hand over the armrest to tender a quasi-shake. Facade is aware of the contemporary dialogue regarding Facebook's privacy rights and the user's reaction to the recent redesign. Facebook's decision to dumb down the site and highlight marketing on the coveted upper right-hand quadrant of the screen has raised some serious questions about its intention to create authentic community. As opposed to doing to get to know you from a formal coffee table chat, Facade prefers to get straight to the point. Excuse me, but before he can, MySpace lets out a kind of wave, beckoning Facebook to join again. You see, it's me and AOL and Friendster and Hotmail. Facebook shrinks in his chair. Oh no, he mumbles. Facebook wants nothing to do with this Mickey Mouse gang, this Donald Ducky club, a bunch of wannabe cool cats who wax ode to Borat and tell your mama jokes. Your mama's so stupid she doesn't even know how to press the play button on the VCR. AOL guffaws through the punchline. Facebook is unable to believe that they are from the same family. Where did the bad genes come from? He searches his past for a biological party, or a different breed. But they keep screaming, and now Friendster yells, hand cupped over mouth, hey cuz, do you remember the time when? And they start singing the theme songs from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Even if Facebook can claim biological independence, meaning that AOL was adopted and Friendster is actually not his real brother but his stepbrother, the reality is that they all know the lines from the Big Lebowski, and that makes them family. Hey cuz, why don't you show them how to walk the chicken? Friendster flaps his bent elbows high in the air. Some of the other ones chuckle across the pages. Ooh, Walker chicken. A new message appears in his inbox. He opens his account. It's from Google. Facebook peruses the pages in front of him and tries to locate her. She's easy to find, elegant, sophisticated. She might as well be the only word on page 469. Their eyes interlock. Facebook breaks the gaze to read his message. Tuesday, 2 p.m., meet me. Facebook stares into the LCD, hand on mouse, spreading over accept. At first, he visualizes the juvenile, a joyride in a Google Maps reveal, a tour of the facility, some free eats in the five restaurants, a spin on the ellipticizer, a 20-minute head and neck massage. But quickly, he realizes that this is just the tip of the iceberg of life with Google. And so Facebook closes his eye, which gives passage to a more phenomenological experience. The picture, Google and Facebook, subterranean, searching for Earth's oldest life form. The underwater apparatus in which they travel slows to take a series of photos of a bacterium encased in salt crystal. The camera's depth of field narrows to capture an extreme close-up of the crystal surface. The aquatic backdrop blurs, the camera steadies. Google whispers, I can take you anywhere, anytime, any place, on land or sea, space. You can see anything, find anyone, I can make your wildest dreams true. Google's hand glides over Facebook's hand. Gently she guides him, interlocks her fingers with his. Just press the button. She cups her hand over his, and together they press down on the mouse. I accept. Message sent. On the rice plate, Facebook expects to feel the rise of the mind process, but instead he experiences a rush of apprehension, a flash of uncertainty. What if she's too much for me? What if she defines me?